please welcome to the court from the United States, Shelby Rogers. And from Latvia, Yelena Ostapenko.
Welcome along to action from the Volvo Car Open here in sunny Charleston. We have a fascinating match for you here as Yelena Ostapenko, former French Open champion, takes on this player right here, Shelby Rogers. What a comeback it was in that first round encounter. Her first match back on tour for over 12 months through that frustrating injury she had. The knee injury that kept her out of the game she loves. And it was a really emotional time when she won that match here on this court in front of her people. She is from this part of the world, and Shelby Rogers back in business. She'll look to kick on here against Ostapenko.
Reminders, if you want me to check a ball mark, please make that very clear for me so I can come straight down. Apart from that, again, with the coaches, let me know, and the clocks are shown big in those corners. Any questions from your end? No? All right. WTA or trophy? Trophy. Trophy it is. Receive. Okay.
So Shelby Rogers did win the toss. This should be really interesting. Ostapenko, the number 10 seed, taking on the wild card, Shelby Rogers. Ostapenko has been a runner-up here in Charleston before. That was a couple of years ago in 2017 when she lost out to Daria Kasatkina in the final. Ostapenko with a good win against Johanna Larsson in the first round, 6-1, 6-4, and Rogers, as we mentioned, coming through against Evgenia Rodina, 6-4, 6-2. Fine performance. And really, after almost 13 months away from the court, it was so impressive. She looked solid, secure, dependable. But this is a much tougher test for Rogers today. With all respect to Rodina, but she's not quite the test of Yelena Ostapenko. There's actually a little issue with the court right now. Julie Kenley nearby, and she's just chatting with the ground staff, because there's a real dip in the back of the court there, so they're going to have to sort that out before the match gets started. Ostapenko, the 21-year-old, career high ranking of world number 5. She has dropped a fair chunk since then. She's now world number 31. And she's not happy here, Ostapenko. She doesn't want to get started. It was a good performance against Larsson. Fired 27 winners. Also fired 27 unforced errors, but that's sort of what you come to expect when you watch Ostapenko. And another thing, a lot of double faults, 7 double faults, which is sort of what she's been averaging this season so far. Well, Shelby Rogers has sat down. Yelena Ostapenko is also, I think, going to head to her bench. So a little bit of a delay here, as we were set to get started. And of course, this is the last thing a player would want, to suffer an injury at the start of the clay court season. So wise just to wait and get this sorted before this match gets started. And the problem is it might just take a little bit of time to sort this issue. Everyone's getting involved here. Is this going to do the trick? Seems to almost be there. That might be enough. I think Yelena Ostapenko just awaiting the A-OK from Julie Clenley, the chair umpire. Well, it was an emotional return to action for Shelby Rogers on Monday, a couple of days ago, winning in two sets to claim that first win in over a year at this, her home tournament. It really couldn't have gone much better for Rogers. She said it was, well, she said it herself, a storybook return. I just think Yelena Ostapenko is the sort of player who will not care that she's up against a Charleston native. She will certainly be thinking about her own game in the nicest possible way. She has her own thing going on, and she will not be sympathetic to Shelby Rogers. Has been a top 50 player, and she is back in the game after that really tough injury to come back from. It there were so many setbacks at the start of the injury when she sustained it at Indian Wells last year. She thought that she could avoid surgery, went for some non-invasive procedures before it was eventually decided knee surgery would absolutely be required, and that was a setback. And well, you could see the tears after she won against Rodina. It means so much, and I think just the fact that it is in front of her home crowd as well just added to all those feelings. She had so much support, and again, she's going to have a huge amount of support here. This is perhaps the standout match of today. Shelby Rogers, one of their own, up against Yelena Ostapenko, a former French Open champion. It's gotten a bit of every. And these two have met once before. It was Ostapenko who won that match on the clay in Rome 2 years ago. Julie Clenley already sorted things out with the court, and now we are looking to get underway. Sunglasses on today. It's been bright and sunny, and the temperature creeping up as the day has gone on. Time just coming up to 2 o'clock here on this Wednesday afternoon. is Yelena Ostapenko's mum slash coach. Trying to keep a low profile. Sunglasses on, hood up. Mark Lucero, coach of Shelby Rogers, who has been there every step of the way in the recovery. And Shelby Rogers scampering over to her team after that win. Actually, her young niece was watching, and Shelby Rogers picking up her niece. And well, it was the two of them who were being interviewed after the match with Andrew Krasny, which was very sweet. This will be such a different task for Shelby Rogers up against Ostapenko. When she's firing, she is too hot to handle for anybody. But the big question is, will she have the consistency? That's always the issue. If she does, then you fancy her chances. Reached the final here 2 years ago. The sixth time that Shelby Rogers has played in the main draw here at the Volvo Car Open. She once worked here as a pool girl, so she really does have a long history with this tournament. Her best ever performance was a quarterfinal run. That came in 2017. She beat Madison Keys and Naomi Osaka along the way.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match will be the best of three tournament sets. Shelby Rogers won the toss and chose to receive.
And we look as if we are set to get underway. Here we go then, Yelena Ostapenko taking on Shelby Rogers. This looks to be a fascinating one here on this Wednesday lunchtime. Nails it. Well, that is one to settle the nerves.
Love her. love court.
Well, this will be a very welcome start here for Shelby Rogers. That's a well saved break point as well. Super serve. Bullseye. Shelby Rogers wasting no time. Oh, they're going to enjoy this afternoon. They'll be looking to get behind her. Breakthrough to start things off. And she's the sort of player, Yelena Ostapenko. You will get chances against her. And Shelby Rogers grabs this first chance.
Shelby Rogers to serve.
Just a little wild on the forehand.
Third field. 30-40.
Bullseye. Saves the break point. Well, breathing a sigh of relief, Shelby Rogers, and I'm sure Mark Lucero feels the same way. That was a good fight from the American. We're seeing that from her. Two games to love. It's a super start, this. She's all over the place right now. Ostapenko not found the radar. And Shelby Rogers, you've got to give a huge credit to her. She is all over this right now. Another break point still. Oh, yeah. Well, that's the ability she possesses, the danger with Ostapenko. She can find winners from anywhere. And it's what has seen her be so dangerous over the past few seasons. So unpredictable.
Advantage Ostapenko.
Out it goes, and Ostapenko is up and running. Rogers gets her first game on the board, but it's a good start this for Shelby Rogers, who leads 2-1.
Gentlemen, please find your seats. Time.
Well, they're enjoying this. Enjoying the sunshine. It's a wonderful place to come and watch tennis here, the Volvo Car Open. Great history, great heritage, and well, great tennis. This is the third match of the day here on this main court.
Fault.
That's good from Ostapenko. Just finding her timing now. She does have good memories here. She was the runner-up a couple of years ago. That was the only other time she played here in Charleston, that 2017 appearance. Oh. That's a little bit of a miscue. And out it goes. It's a break to love.
Two games.
During the Sunshine Double, made the third round in Indian Wells, lost out to Marketa Vondrousova, and the second round in Miami, also lost to Vondrousova. Shelby Rogers is just spraying the ball about a bit here. It's a good run of games, this, for Yelena Ostapenko. And she now leads the way in this first set. Early days, but she leads 3-2.
The exclusive racket and ball, the Volvo Car Open, Dunlop Sports, will be showcasing the new Dunlop Strixon line of rackets for demonstration and purchase, as well as their full line of tennis products. Be sure to pick up a giant tennis ball that's perfect for those player autographs. Make sure you visit the Dunlop booth located at the interactive zone next to Sponsor Row. O2 Fitness continues to expand across the Tri-County area. Our new Daniel Island Club in Central Island Square, featuring unlimited group fitness classes, personal training, and child care, will be opening soon. O2 Fitness has 11 clubs across the Lowcountry. Visit an O2 Fitness club near you. Sign up for your free trial at o2fitnessclubs.com.
Oh, she was so unhappy there, Shelby Rogers. She left her racket lying in the dirt. Giving it time to think about what it did. It's an untidy few games for Shelby Rogers. But it's on serve, this first set. Just over 20 minutes played.
Third 14-11.
Superb. Back to business. Service hold to love for Shelby Rogers. It's been a lovely day today. Sun has been shining high in the sky. Oh, yeah.
15.
Well constructed from Ostapenko. One of eight former finalists in the starting field. Beat Johanna Larsson in the first round. Actually, she beat the Swede in the first round en route to her most recent title on tour. That was Seoul in 2017, so perhaps that is just something to hang your hat on. Good omen, perhaps.
Let for seven.
Oh, yeah, that's a superb strike.
Yes. advantage, Ostapenko.
Overcooks that one. It's an important game, this one. That's just too easy for Ostapenko. It's a quick error. And Shelby Rogers has another chance here. Out it goes. Shelby Rogers jumps in front. And this crowd enjoying this already.
Rogers leads
4-3.
Ball changing.
Make sure to download the official tournament app. Your service for up-to-the-minute schedules, scores, and stats. Get ranking news stories.
Ждешь ногами, двигайся к мячу ногами, не замедляя руку. Все, и заставь ее подвигаться. Заставляй ее двигаться. Она плотно бьет в основном в секунду. Да, два мяча. Два мяча, тебе надо ее в розыгрыш заценить. Слева она бьет почти все время, левую. Готовься. Как бы, не спеши, не замедляй руку. Играй в свою. Ничего, 4-3 еще тут еще. Играй в свою удовольствие. Работай ногами и не замедляй руку. Все. Да? Не замедляй руку, все. Двигайся на мяч, пожалуйста. Все нормально. Все нормально. Давай, она тоже когда играла. Она все не чувствует. Нет, ты не проиграешь. Ты ее будешь двигаться. Ты что? Ты просто сейчас ей подарила все. Быстрей готовься. Быстрей готовься. Она когда играла с Лисичей Баронин в 2017 году, на первый сет выиграла, а потом все.
So, a word from Mum at the change of ends for Yelena Ostapenko. She's not best pleased at the moment, the number 10 seed, but still a long way to go. And it is just the break of serve that Rogers has right now. But yeah, Ostapenko needs to tighten things up because these are too many unforced errors from her. There is Yelena's mum just think it's so impressive what Rogers is doing here in these first couple of rounds at this year's Volvo Car Open. She hasn't played a competitive match for over 12 months. The first round, she was outstanding. Just had that clinical edge, that competitive nature about it. She's got it here again. It's not easy just to flip the switch and get back into the groove. But she's doing that. Game away from taking this opening set now.
Rogers leads 5-3.
Oh, can Ostapenko just ensure that Shelby Rogers has to close out this first set herself? Pop it away. Sent back at quite a pace. Shelby Rogers absolutely cracked that forehand. Ferocious.
Advantage Ostapenko.
So it will be over to you, Shelby. Can you close out this first set? Ostapenko ensures that she keeps it open. 5-4, Rogers.
Make sure to pick up a limited edition 2019 Volvo Coke. You can choose from 9-ounce Terms wine or 16 and 24-ounce tumblers. Purchase them here on site at concession stands or bars and receive complimentary water and soda refills from self-serve refill stations located at Volvo Car Stadium and Althea Gibson Club Court. And this year's Volvo Car Stadium Concert Series features an incredible lineup. Why Don't We, August 20th. The Tedeschi Trust Band, July 5th. And Kenny Chesney, April 25th. Tickets are on sale now. For a complete schedule and ticket availability, visit the box office or go to VolvoCarStadiumConcerts.com.
Well, so far it's been a pretty impressive second showing of the week here for Shelby Rogers. I'm sure a few might have thought, well, that first round, maybe that was a flash in the pan after coming back and this might be a bit more difficult. But Shelby Rogers has shown that she is ready for this comeback. She's not rushed back. She's worked on her fitness. She's worked on her game. And she's recovered sufficiently to really compete at this highest level.
Law 50.
It's always one of those difficult things to judge if a player is ready to come back. And it certainly does look that Shelby Rogers is. Nice work from Rogers. Ostapenko's not convinced by this, but Julie Glenley says it's pretty far out. No need to get down and check. And it's set points Rogers. Still a set point in the pocket. No, not yet.
Deuce. advantage Ostapenko.
Ostapenko fighting back here. It is another set point. Well, that seals it. First set in the bag. Shelby Rogers, she means business here in Charleston. Takes the first set.
Ms. Rogers has requested.
The contact point needs to be higher, but if you can't get up there to go higher, use a kick, because the kick's giving her all kinds of trouble, especially on the first. If she's not like looking for it necessarily, start mixing in some kick, like she's gonna be all over the place. Doing a great job mixing locations on the second. It's been a really good adjustment. And the one thing early, like if you get one or two points in a row here, like let her know that you're here, you know what I mean? Like bluff it, you know what I mean? If you need to, like, but you got to project that energy that she's got to do something straight, because she doesn't know what's going on, you know what I mean? So you go out there, good energy, make her play some good shots. If she doesn't, like, get one or two little momentum, let these people help you out.
Yeah.
But just project that image, like, man, you're here, you're going to freaking fight, and whatever happens, happens, but you're going to give her 100% of what you have. And just with the kick, use the kick. Or use like a hard slice. But just give yourself a big target. If you want to use middle of the box body, it's a good target on the first. As long as you give it a little something on it, you know. And if you... I would look for more forehands on the second. So I would back up to give yourself time, you know, to look, like a little, just a little more room to look for it. But that's really it. Every time you hit a forehand on the second serve, like giving her all kinds of trouble. So just, you know, if it's too fast when you're in close to get around the backhand, just back up a little bit. And then, boom, heavy forehand, big swing. Okay, come on, Judd.
Ladies and gentlemen, please find your seats. Time.
Yeah, interesting chat there with Mark Lucero and Shelby Rogers. Just have the change of ends at the end of that first set.
Second sentence. Ostapenko to serve.
I think perhaps Shelby Rogers, even though she took the first set, a little low of energy, and Mark Lucero is just saying, look, if you win a couple of points in a row, let Ostapenko know that you're here, and then if you get that energy up, the crowd will help you out as well.
30 left.
No holding back there. Well, it's a solid game that from Ostapenko.
First game, second.
And she needs to start making a move here and to impose herself on this encounter because she was just a little off in the first set. Actually, looking at the stats, there wasn't a huge amount in it. Just that break of serve extra for Shelby Rogers. But Ostapenko very much has this within her to turn this one around. Well, Ostapenko thought there was a shot from Rogers that was out there, looking accusingly at the court. Well, that sort of point just plays into the hands, doesn't it, of Shelby Rogers. Nowhere near. Yeah, she's looking to really get off to a solid start, Ostapenko, in this second set.
Advantage, Ostapenko.
That's the way to save a break point. Nails that one. And Ostapenko, oh, she's determined to make herself hurt here. Wonderfully constructed. Well, that is a very gutsy hold.
One game.
And Yelena Ostapenko, well, had an opportunity there, but couldn't find the break. Shelby Rogers, she needs this crowd to really get behind her and help her over the line. It's got that easy power. Oh, brilliant.
40-50. game, Ostapenko.
Well, it is Ostapenko who gets a nose in front.
Two games to one.
It's all pretty close, though. Early stage of this second set. That's a good idea. Snack time. An hour played here in this second round encounter, and it's proving tough to call which way this is going to go.
Love 15.
Crowd enjoying themselves today, soaking up the sunshine. Much better than yesterday. It was wet and windy yesterday. Oh, she's got this. That's the way to save one. It is away.
Love game, Ostapenko. Ostapenko wins 3-1.
With a bit of a lead now, 3-1, as this second set is just going her way. I just think Shelby Rogers is just taking her foot off the gas.
Love it.
She's got that way about her, hasn't she? Ostapenko asked the question after every single point. Keeping Julie Klenly busy. Fired away. Fourth double fault for Ostapenko. Julie Klenly is being kept busy here. That is clearly out. You can see the mark. It's that sort of set. It's all a bit topsy-turvy. There's not really too much of a rhyme or reason to it. Rogers trails.
Ostapenko leads 3-2.
Founder of Raised in the South, which also is the 2017 winner of the Food Network's Great Food Truck Race, and they are here at the top of the tier in the
Where will this go next?
Law 15.
You can sort of never guess with Ostapenko because she can fire at a few winners in a row, but then a few unforced errors are hot on the heels. Tough to get any real rhythm.30 all. That's wonderful quality. Look at that. Spectacular. It is topsy-turvy. Ostapenko deciding now is a good time just to change up the racket. World number 31 right now, Ostapenko. Of course, she has been much higher. She's been as high as world number 5. It's not been a year to shout about for her. She's really struggled for wins on tour.
15.
Okay,
away that goes. And Ostapenko, she's finding it really tough just to wriggle clear of Shelby Rogers in this set. It's an absolute roller coaster, this one. So topsy-turvy as Rogers has break point.
Use.
One game will do it now for Ostapenko in his second set as Mum leads the applause. She's nearly pulled clear, 5-2. Skips out to serve Shelby Rogers.
Sit quickly, please.
But she is on the brink of losing this second set. Well, again, this is going to require Julie Glenley to come and make absolutely sure it is out. Second serve. She's got this one. She'd love to get this set over the line here, Ostapenko. It would mean she would kick off the third set serving. And Rogers does keep this second set in the balance. But Ostapenko can close it up here. Just away. It's been a bit of a struggle this for Ostapenko. More like it. 30-50. Away as it brings up set points for the Latvian. To seal the deal and take us to a third set. Well, that was past Ostapenko in a flash. It is a third we require. And who can hold their nerve as we move into a deciding set in this second round encounter? Ostapenko hits back.
Ladies and gentlemen, please find your seats. Time. Final seconds. Rogers.
So it is a third set we require. I think for both these players it's going to be a case of who can just tidy up the errors. It's a lovely serve. First ace of this deciding set. It's ace number four for Rogers in this match. Ostapenko hasn't found an ace yet.
40-30.
It's been a close one, this. These two meeting for the second time. They did meet in Rome a couple of years ago. Ostapenko won that one in straight sets. And it is break point right away here for Yelena Ostapenko. And she looks to try and get a vice-like grip on this match. Ostapenko thinks this is out. No, I think she thinks it was a let, actually. That seems to be what she's suggesting, because it wasn't out. She was under pressure there, back against the wall of Shelby Rogers. But she's had to dig deep. And she's getting support from this crowd. Shout out, good job, Shelby, raining down from the stands. Let's see how the second set worked out. 12 winners, 7 unforced errors. Good ratio for Ostapenko. That first serve percentage, way too low, though, for her. It's a major problem for her, the serve. Break points, a couple compared to just the one for Rogers. But who could kick on and take this third? It is very much up for grabs.
Yeah.
KPFT.
Shelby Rogers coming to meet that with aplomb.
Not a great effort that from Ostapenko. Half court. Great point here. Shelby Rogers getting stronger.
Rogers leads 2-1.
Away. So quick to trigger, so quick to go for that winner. Sure about the choice sometimes. Frustration for Ostapenko. Got to say that happened coming. Shelby Rogers has made a break for it here. Leads the way 3-love.
Rogers leads 3-1. Ты много ошибаешься, сама ты много подарков делаешь. Немножко гоняй ее, она же не бегает вообще, гоняй. И не надо так сильно бить. Слышишь? Просто погоняй ее, короткий крусик. Не можешь принять слева, она подает тебе кит подлево. Срезай, нормально, двигай. Там, когда на гейм. Ну что, ты все можешь вернуть, пока только твои ошибки. Все, ты простые мячи ошибаешься. Тело ей принимай. Слышишь? Тело ей под право принимай. Будь резко только, да, не замедляй руку.
Все, двигайся, двигайся, заставляй ее двигаться. Сама работает. Все нормально.
For new board, 3 games.
Needs to refocus here on Ostapenko because this is going in the wrong direction for her. Fire away. Our mum came out and spoke to Yelena Ostapenko at the change of ends there. Have to be careful with that. Oh, that's just outstanding play. And Shelby Rogers determined not to give Yelena Ostapenko a look in here. Supreme hitting. And this is going the way of the American even further. Mark Lucero enjoying what he's seeing. Out it goes. 4 games to love. Shelby Rogers. They're loving it.
Rogers leads 4 games to love.
And look at that for a reaction. It's great to see.
Love 15.
Well finished off. That took a lot of control from Ostapenko. Well, to get up and running. Saves a couple of break points. Just about lands in. It was a brave angle. I mean, you've got to credit Ostapenko. Even when she's four love down in the deciding set, she's still going for things. Never back down. So this isn't going to be plain sailing for Shelby Rogers. Ostapenko is on the board. Rogers leads the way though, 4-1.
So is this just to be a minor speed bump for Shelby Rogers on her route to victory, or perhaps this is the start of a very real comeback from Yelena Ostapenko? Took her a while to get that first game. That's a beauty of a backhand. 15. It's a bit of a worry, this, for Rogers, because Ostapenko is starting to find the target with more regularity. Super. It was such a good return. Quality. 14 under. It's just surprising, isn't it, that depth of shot that Ostapenko is able to pull out of the bag just at will from anywhere. Goes. It is two games that Ostapenko has almost got back on Rogers. But Rogers is trying to hold Ostapenko off. And this is a very hard-fought game, this one. Nails this one. That's an absolute scorcher. Look at that. But how's that for a response? Whatever you can do, I can do. As these two are turning up the heat.
Is this to be the key moment? These two just wrestling out there. What a way to save the break point. What a tightrope, this one. Chance for Rogers. Goes one game away.
Ball change, please.
She ball wants more.
5 games to one.
Ostapenko, she has a mountain to climb here. It has been a disappointing season for her. Five match wins all season for Ostapenko. She's had 8 defeats.
59.
What a gutsy showing this has been. Thought she was impressive in her first round, but this has been just another example of the fight that she possesses. Find a way. Slammed it in.
30, 40.
Yeah, it's landed inside the baseline. I don't think there's much doubt. Shelby Rogers is pretty convinced.
Game Ostapenko.
And she says that's fine. Ostapenko is alive and kicking. We go on here.
5-2.
So was that just a little bit of a wobble there for Rogers? There's no either or, is there, with Ostapenko? She will always go for that line. First ace this for Ostapenko. It's match point. Oh, that's a super shot. Rips that backhand. I mean, the winners are stacking up big time for Ostapenko. That's 32 now. 18 on the backhand side. And Liz, back over to you, Sheldon. Can you close it out again?
5-3.
Another chance. She's found another. And this is getting a little untidy now for Shelby Rogers because it's gone from 5-1 to 5-3. And Ostapenko is not missing too many now. And she is wavering. And Shelby's got to keep it away from that backhand. That is a monster right now. The backhand in overdrive. And it's doing all the damage. This might be out. It is. Julie Glenley confirming 5-1 has become 5-4.
Game of the bank. Rogers leads 5-4.
Time.
Oh, what a comeback this has been from Ostapenko. And she can't miss right now. Shelby Rogers is a little all over the place. Brilliant. On it in a flash. Well, perhaps Shelby Rogers was just ramping up the entertainment, leaving it till late.
Advantage, Ostapenko.
Goes. It's five games apiece. What a recovery from Ostapenko. She was 5-1 down. Yeah, this is going in one direction.
Love Fortune.
Ostapenko really turning the screw. It's break points. Wild one. Ostapenko moves the game away.
6-5.
She leads 6-5. Well, they're still trying to get behind Shelby Rogers. But Yelena Ostapenko, has she just broken the resistance of the American? Yelena Ostapenko sometimes has some troubles getting over the line. Double fault creeps in. Maybe we do require a tiebreak. Break points galore. There goes one.
It is a tie break we need. And listen to the noise now.
Six games all.
Shelby Rogers, it looked as if she was out of this. It is a tie break. She has pulled a rabbit from the hat with a little help from Yelena Ostapenko. She might still do this, you know. Oh, never looked settled with that. It was an awkward bounce for Ostapenko. It's a wild one.
3-2,
Ostapenko. Ostapenko sneaks in front. Who is going to take this? She will give you chances, though. This is wide open. And after almost 2.5 hours, it all comes down to these next few points. It doesn't matter what's come before. It's who can manage this situation. She must be feeling it, Shelby Rogers. I mean, she's been away from the game for over a year. Incredible fight.
pulled the trigger early there. That's more like it. Ostapenko rips it away. What a put away. A gutsy finish from Ostapenko. It sat up for an age. And she is nearly there. And that will seal it. Yelena Ostapenko gets the win in three sets against a resilient Shelby Rogers.
Thank you.
Great fight, says Yelena Ostapenko. It certainly was. But it is the number 10 seed left smiling. A former runner-up here. And she's got the winning feeling in 2019 in this wonderful city. Shelby Rogers, well, she will get a fantastic ovation, I'm sure, after all the efforts, after the comeback, the recovery. This is where she wants to be. And she gave that an almighty effort. Almost came through. Off she goes. She's back. And she's not going anywhere. Great to see. Let's hear from Ostapenko.
That was a nail-biter, to say the least. And what a comeback from you in the third set. An incredible effort from you.
You know, honestly, I don't know how I did it because she was playing so well and she came back after injury. It's really great to see her back. You know, she's a great player. So I was just trying, you know, to fight because I'm a fighter. So I was trying to show that I'm fighting. And I think then the little, like, some moments and the game turned my way. And, guys, of course, you were, like, I was not the favorite on this match, but great support, and actually I enjoyed so much playing in front of you guys.
We say this all the time. Charleston fans are very respectful. Of course, she's a hometown favorite, but they respect the fight from you, and you did fight. What was it in the match that allowed you to turn things around? I know you're a fighter. What kind of adjustments to your game, Alona?
Of course, they were very respectful. I honestly expected something more, and they were really nice guys. And again, thank you so much for coming and watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And I was just, you know, as I said, trying to fight as I could. And because tennis is this game when one moment can turn the other way, and then the match goes, you know, the other way. So you really have to fight for every ball. And that's what I did today.
And as you get your confidence back heading towards the clay court season, how much does this do for your deep down confidence?
Of course, it's great to get some confidence because I was injured in the last season. At the end of the season, I was injured and I couldn't play for 3 months. So it's very tough to come back after injury, as I know, and of course for Shelby also. And really happy to see her back. And I'm just glad that I won and really looking forward for my next match.
All right, through to the next round. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen, Yelena Ostapenko.
It's always nice to hear from Yelena Ostapenko, and Yeah, quite right. There was a lot of support here for Shelby Rogers, but they are a respectful crowd and they like what they've seen from Ostapenko. A runner-up here in 2016, and who knows about this year. Ostapenko rocking and rolling as she gets into round three. And that is our third match, done and dusted, here on this Volvo Car Stadium court. Still a few to come today. 2.5 hours required for this one, and Ostapenko came from a set down. Great fight from her, Shelby Rogers. She was so close to coming through herself. She had match point. She couldn't get it done. And Ostapenko fought back from 5-1 down in the third set. And she did it, hitting a lot of winners. Backhand winners in particular, outstanding. Able to find 21 backhand winners today. It all